Hi, dudes. So here we are today. The features on the App Store just refreshed, and we got a little bit of a surprise because there was a brand new Star Wars game that didn't appear anywhere until it was up on the App Store for download. So I figured we could give this a try. It's called Star Wars Journeys: The Phantom Menace, and let's check out the iTunes text real quick here. It mentions like more stuff coming on the way, like both in other oh, hang on, let me fix this. Both in additional Star Wars titles as well as potentially new content for this particular Star Wars game. So that seems pretty neat. I figured we'd give it a once over because it's kind of it's a little on the expensive side for an iOS game at $7, so let's give this the old try here. See what it's all about. All right, so it looks like it's doing one of those things where it has to download stuff before you start playing, maybe? Either way, it's this makes for exciting streaming. Let's see if I can move this stuff to not have a shadow here. That's decent. All right. So, first things first, looks like we have, what do we got here? Yeah, multiple. Oh no, I guess these are not like character profiles, maybe. I thought that would be, like different save game stuff or whatever else. So, let's see what kind of settings we've got here. Music, sound effect, narration. Is there narration? Alright, cool. So I don't need to read anything, I guess. Different buttons. So here's the help for the story mover device, left and right, or scroll with your finger to experience a full story scene. Tap to flag. So basically, multi-touch gestures do various junk. So I guess let's hop right into the story experience here. Right. Let's experience the full story scene here. I don't want to move my device right or left. All right, fine. Fine, you win. I will tilt. So, tap to click Star Wars profiles. What does it want me to collect here? I really have to severely tilt to see everything. I don't know what it's trying to get me to collect. Alright, spread your fingers apart to go to the next story scene. Your fingers in to go to the previous ones. This seems like kind of like a comic book-ish thing.
The Greedy Trade Federation is invading the peaceful planet of Naboo. Battleships carrying
Alright, so the Greedy
thousands of
Trade Federation
droids
is
and war
invading the peaceful
machines
planet of
are headed
Naboo.
to the capital city of
Battleships
Theed,
carrying thousands of droids and
determined
war
to
machines are heading to
overthrow
the capital
Queen
city of
Amidala.
Theed, determined
Jedi
to
Master
overthrow
Qui-Gon
Queen
Jinn and his
Amidala. Jedi
apprentice
Master
Obi-Wan
Qui-Gon
Kenobi
Jinn and his
have been
apprentice
sent
Obi-Wan
as
Kenobi have been
peacekeepers by the
sent as
Galactic Republic.
peacekeepers by the Galactic
Their
Republic.
Republic cruiser
The
lands
Republic
in the Trade
cruiser lands
Federation's
in the
immense
Trade
droid control
Federation's
ship.
immense droid control ship. So this basically kind of seems like the movie, I guess. Which I don't know. I mean, that's sort of cool, right? I guess maybe. I'm just making sure. All right, yeah, cool. How do I? Okay, so I can control my finger now. So. I picked something up there. I'm just kind of like randomly tapping to make sure I'm not missing anything. Guess not. Alright, so. Go to the next scene here, which
Unknown to
is
the
them.
Jedi,
Remember the
Luke Gunray,
Jedi,
loyal leader
Nate
of the Trade
Gunray,
Federation, is
the
taking his orders
Millennium
from a fearsome
Falcon
Sith
leader.
Lord.
The Trade Federation is taking orders from a fearsome Sith Lord, Darth Sidious. He orders them to eliminate the Jedi. Points this gas pumped into the room, but Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan hold their breath. Igniting lightsabers, they cut down the droids in their path. The droid decoys with shields force a standoff. So the Jedi sneak down to the planet to warn the Naboo of the coming invasion. Kind of was expecting this to be more of, I guess a, adventure game sort of thing. That's what the screenshots look like, you know. Instead of like a weird kind of. Alright, so I unlocked the Droidica Destroyer droid. Unlock more of his profile by completing pod races. Okay. So, let's see what we got here. Tapping those to nothing.
They have shield generators. Master, destroy it.
Right, so next
the
scene,
Greedy Trade Federation is invading the peaceful planet.
No, sorry. You zoom in to go. Unknown to the Jedi. Proceed.
Trade Federation tanks are right, causing so the creatures and beasts of Naboo to stampede.
Trade Federation tanks are cruising, are causing the creatures and beasts of Naboo to stampede. A clumsy Gungan named Jar Jar Binks is about to run over when Qui-Gon rescues him. Shows gratitude, Jar Jar guides the Jedi to the secret Gungan city of Ota Gunga. They dive into a deep lake and swim down towards the underwater kingdom. Qui-Gon profile. Doesn't seem like tapping anything anywhere does anything. Alright, Obi-Wan Kenobi. That's cool, right? Oh, so this is showing the different scenes that we can go through. This is like... Alright, so we basically have the movie in scenes. Like, why wouldn't you just want to watch the movie? Alright, well here, let's see what the pod racing stuff is like, I guess. This could be cool. Alright, so Anakin Skywalker is equipped, so how do we race? Quick race, track one. Easy difficulty, just to see what it's like. Alright, so racing controls. I definitely want to use buttons. More brake. Okay, cool. This is sort of new. I wish I remembered more about the Nintendo 64 pod racing game to know how close this is to the. So I think Twitch might be having some issues with the chat stuff. Like I don't seem like I can connect to it on my end, so you guys can't get to chat, that's probably why. And I follow the Twitch support thing on Twitter and it seems like they're just constantly having problems. What's really weird about this is like I feel like they could very easily have just sold this as a pod racer. Like I don't know why they decided to go for the whole animated storybook thing is what
kind of gets the lead in iTunes featuring. So this is the third of three laps. This is, that's kind of a long way to go. I should use the boost more. I feel like the Nintendo 64 Pod Racer had way more personality between the racers. Well, maybe I guess you just have to unlock them by reading the story. It seems like a really weird mishmash of gameplay and things. So where's Sebulba? And I got 590 story points. That's cool, right? Which way do I need to move this so you guys can see it? I guess that's pretty good. Can I play as another dude? I don't have enough of the SPs. Can I get more? Can I buy more? Need more story points. Earn story points by completing pod races or finding Star Wars profiles. I want to unlock Sebulba. Alright, well, let's see what else we got in this, as far as tracks are concerned. So that was track one, which there are 12 tracks total, but some of them you can see are like the inverse tracks. So I guess we'll just move on to track two. Let's do medium, because easy was kind of stupid. Alright, so Tatooine track two here. I wonder if they all sort of use the same... These dudes definitely seem way more aggressive. I decided what direction I wanted to go in. That, I guess, is like my hull strength or whatever. When you use your thrusters. I'll turn the game down. Everyone was complaining about everything being too soft yesterday, and I turn it up and it's too loud today. Alright. Oh shit, I didn't mean to retry. Well, whatever. Kind of like sight bike like mechanic in that you want to be balancing how much boost you use versus your engine temperature or whatever. Maybe, I guess you're in a pod, so maybe you just can't break. That would make sense, right? Could really use some kind of mini-map for where I'm supposed to go, like, especially when you get in those wide open areas, it's not really clear if you're supposed to go right or left. Additionally, the three races, or three laps feels really long on these. Especially for a mobile game, like, that's kind of a long session. Oh shit. Oh, this guy got stuck too. That guy ran me, that's cool. Seems like in medium it's hard to get above, like, third. Oh good, I'm in first place, but that dude rammed me so hard that I have now, like, 30% health. This seems like a strange release. Like, it came out of the blue. I don't know, like, is there anything Star Wars going on that it would make sense for them to release a Episode 1 story / racing game? I don't know. Oh, that dude. Oh, look at the time split of the top three there. So 309 and 1/100ths of a second. That puts me at number four. The split is just ridiculous though. Oh well, whatever. I'm gonna exit on that. Let's try another course. I guess I only have one dude of which I can race. So does this seem like a, so this is Tatooine as well. All right, I'm gonna keep going through these until we get one that doesn't seem like, or one that's not in Tatooine. So track one seems like it's, yeah, track one is the same as track four, but inverted. All right, so let's check out what track seven's all about. Again, more Tatooine. All right, well, I guess that must be all that's included. I feel like on the Nintendo 64 game, you could use the triggers to kind of like sharply turn. Unless I'm remembering it incorrectly. I'm like following the NPC racers, but they're leading me astray here. These guys are super aggressive when it comes to running into you. Yeah, I bought the Nintendo 64 expansion pack for this too. I didn't feel like it did almost nothing. I don't really remember, but I don't think it kind of like blew me away when I plugged the thing in. So last lap here. So it seems like this game has a lot of rubber banding, to the point that like the three laps you do are almost insignificant compared to just boosting like crazy over the finish line. Cause like look how close again everyone is, right? Like this is kind of crazy, the amount of rubber banding and crap. Like that's, I don't know. So. Third place gets me 75 SP. Alright, let's try. We'll just quickly go through the other couple tracks. So we know tracks 1 through 3 are Tatooine, 4, 5, and 6 are inverse of those, so it makes sense that they would not be any different. So let's try track 8. Alright, so track 8 is Tatooine again. Let's see what track 9 is all about. I'm kind of disappointed by this. Like, I was expecting there to be more to it, right? So, at $7, like, this is definitely on the... here, let's just go to track 12. I'm sure this will also be Tatooine, but... At $7, this is near the top end of kind of what is, you know, acceptable on the App Store, it seems like, and... You know, aside from the Star Wars licensing, there's not a whole lot. I just got an email from Disney about this, with the subject, "May the 4th be with you." Yeah, so this one through the little town here is a little more tricky, but... So this is sort of boring. Here, let's go. I'll show you guys what the main area. Well, I mean, I guess I don't know what the main function of the game is supposed to be. So this is the racing portion, right? But then I can go out to the main menu, and this is kind of what I started with here, is the story experience. So you know, you would think that like. The story experience would tie in with the pod racing in some cool way, but in actuality, like, all you can kind of do is just zoom through these different things, and you kind of like, you know, like here we're with the Gungan boss now, and you can kind of swipe side to side and look around, and I can like tap stuff randomly to get points or otherwise interact with the background. And then, you know, once you've determined that that's kind of all you can do, you do your multi-touch gesture to zoom in again. And, you know, so this is where they get the thing, the submarine. We're going on a submarine adventure. Again, you can pan around, and so I got 100 points for discovering that thing in the story world. And 100 points for that too. So those seem to be the same points that you spend on like your pod, I guess. Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan surprised. So here we are fighting droids. Jar Jar, of course, is being Jar Jar. The queen to let them take her to safety on the planet Coruscant, capital of the Galactic Republic. But as they Alright, so I got that dude.
Trade Federation battleships open fire. The Queen's ship is damaged,
but a brave astromech droid, R2-D2, makes
it's real weird, right? Like, this seems like a really strange way to use the Star Wars IP, right? Like, I get the interactive storybook thing, but I mean, there's really not a whole lot to it. This desert planet is a lawless place. And then, like, random tapping, like, reading the tiny bit of text, which is, like, the most Cliff Notes-y version of the movie imaginable, right? Qui-Gon negotiates with Watto, the Tordarian shop owner. Padme meets young Anakin Skywalker. Tapping around, see what we can get. And you can see here on the, well, I don't know how to get that menu to come back up, but it, you know, gives us, like, a bar for how much of the story we've explored here. Alright, so, blah, 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 Anakin betting Watto, there's C-3PO, and R2-D2. And he even shows Padme a droid he built from scraps and named C-3PO. Anakin also tells Qui-Gon about the pod racer he built. Pod racer pilots drive their vehicles at incredible speeds. Anakin. So yeah, I don't know. This is
next day is the Boonta Eve pod race. Anakin speeds
not
through
very
canyons
exciting.
And over salt flats. He nearly loses to Sebulba the Dug, who uses dirty tricks.
Here's the pod race, you know, like they do in the movie.
But it's Sebulba who ends up crashing. Anakin races across.
Seems like another game that is good with my new camera setup, because you can kind of see like the frantic swiping and things like that that I'm doing to kind of get this to do anything.
Qui-Gon begins a ferocious duel with the evil Sith, while Anakin scrambles aboard to alert Obi-Wan and Padme.
So they're fighting with Darth Maul.
They swoop down, and Qui-Gon is able to jump to safety.
Got that dude's thing.
With the ship's hyperdrive repaired, the Jedi bring Queen Amidala to Coruscant, where she hopes to get help and save her planet.
I guess we'll go to the next one. I don't know, like this. I mean, there's not, it doesn't say there's any in-app purchase on this, so I don't know. I mean, like, what's kind of crazy with stuff like this is that we're kind of looking at it in the weird ecosystem that is iOS games, right? Whereas, like, if you were going out to buy a book for your kid. Alright, so here you've unlocked part of the profile. Unlock more of this profile by completing pod races. So let's see what that does. So let's see if we can race as Yoda or do anything like that. Alright, so it doesn't look like we can, but we do have enough. 2100 is enough to buy this pod. So that's cool. Alright, so I guess let's race and see what happens. So we're racing for Yoda's thing. So we'll go to a track we haven't done before, like I don't think I did track 8 maybe. I went to this week I went to San Diego to do the Tony Hawk thing. That's where we got the video of Tony Hawk playing this game from. It actually like went out to Tony Hawk Inc. and hung out with Tony Hawk, and he did the demo thing and gave me a tour and sorts of junk like that. It was pretty cool. Alright, so this new pod seems functionally identical to my old pod. A little slower, but it seems like I can boost for longer. Yeah, I think the Tony Hawk thing will be good. Like, I don't know, it's not what people that wanted a Tony Hawk game were looking for, but at the same time, I think it'll do really, really well. Because it's a pretty good mobile game, even though it's not, you know, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2, which is what to learn the Tony Hawk really wanted. I don't want to keep racing to unlock junk. Well, here, let's just go back to the story thing, because I have a feeling that playing this race with Yoda is going to amount to absolutely nothing. Alright, so how do we get back to the title screen?
On Coruscant,
Alright, so I guess we'll just go through this real quick, see how long it is. Anyway, as I was saying, like, the, if you're gonna go out and buy your kids, like, a Star Wars book, you know, you'd spend way more than $7 on it. And this is, like, on the iPad, and is vaguely interactive, and it has a little game associated with it, so... I don't know. I guess when you're comparing it to iOS games, its functionality and $7 feels very, very limited, right? But when you're comparing it to, like, you know, the books or whatever that exist, you know, if you go into a bookstore of any kind, there's Star Wars books for days, right? Alright, so I guess that's all I can do in this one.
Back in Dallas, Newt Gunray has surrounded Padme, Captain Panaka, and their friends. But the wily queen outwits the greedy viceroy by using a hidden blaster in the throne room of Theed Palace. After destroying the remaining droids,
I want to, like, maybe download a Nintendo 64 emulator or whatever else. Like, I might even have the Podracer cartridge around here somewhere. To see how different the racing in this is. Because, I mean, you figure... getting some kind of, like, weirdly interactive book if you're a kid, like, that seems pretty good. The Pod Racer port is decent. I mean, it's not going to change my life, but... oh, cool, I got a point for the lightsaber there. All right.
Meanwhile, the space battle rages. Anakin flies his starfighter
straight into the droid. So this is, like, the space battle that happens at the end of the movie. Where he's quickly surrounded by droidicas.
I feel like it would get boring as a kid to just, like, constantly be rereading the plot of Star Wars movies, but I don't know. At his funeral, Qui-Gon Jinn's many friends and fellow Jedi. All right, so then we have the
yet they take funeral thing here. Oh, my story explored is near 100% here. Although my profile's unlocked is like half. Like, I wonder what other junk I could have been clicking. I mean, I have been pretty wildly tapping, right?
Yoda makes Obi-Wan a Jedi Knight and honors his master's last request. The Republic's newly elected leader, Supreme Chancellor Palpatine, had arrived with the Jedi Council. The next day, a great parade streams through the streets in celebration of the Republic's triumph and restoration of peace on Naboo. In the central plaza of Theed City, the people cheer for their nation's defenders.
Right, and so I guess that's it for this one. Now let's see what happens. So it kicks us back out, like, that's the story experience, and then the pod racing is kind of all there is left in the game. I don't know, I mean, I guess if you're a kid that's really into Star Wars stuff, this probably, like, really does it for you. You know, especially as, like, you... oh, okay, here, so check this out. So this is a profile here that is unlocked. Or, I'm sorry, it's totally locked right now. So I just this came from me tapping Qui-Gon Jinn in the story. Whereas when I was racing the pod racer, I had this one selected, I think. And when you do that, it gives you, like, the, you know, little bio info, I guess, and, like, how big it is and your top speed and all that junk, which I don't know. I mean, I guess... cool. It's not entirely what I expected, but I don't know. I guess that's the new Star Wars game, Star Wars Journeys, The Phantom Menace. Allegedly, there's more stuff coming. I don't know what else they could possibly add to this, considering, like, it encapsulates the entire movie. So yeah, I don't know. What should we play now? I guess I can check up on my Boom Beach. I haven't done that in a while. Oh, my base got destroyed. Well, it's not surprising. I had a ton of resources. All right, so let's take a look at this jerk, level 21. All right, so what did this guy do?
Oh, using the trees. That's tricky. Alright, so this guy definitely knows how to play. Can see why he beat me now. I didn't play much of Republic. I don't know. We had tons of coverage of it, so I just kind of focused my efforts elsewhere. This guy's super tricky, though. Like, look at that. I didn't even know that you could steer dudes around the back like that. I guess I'm gonna have to rethink my like front cannon thing that I got going on here. Just kind of curious how many dudes he had left when I finally die. This is a really good attack though, I'm impressed by this. It makes me want to try this strategy with other people's bases. Because I have the have pretty advanced flares because I've been training those up. So yeah, I guess at this point the basically got it in the bag. It was close though. That was really close. These dudes are mostly dead. Yeah. Huh. All right. Well, whatever. I'm fine with that. Claim my reward. I'll just upgrade something just for fun to keep it cooking, but yeah, like I don't know, I'm like totally bored with this now. Like this is basically the extent of me playing, is kind of like just upgrading something and then, you know, coming back when the timer's done or whatever else like that. So no, we can, here, I'll show you guys. So I've kind of significantly upgraded the warrior guy in Wayward Souls. Let's see, I need to adjust the delay on my camera. It's getting not matched up. All right, where is the options here? Yeah, cause like it doesn't invert the screen. Right, okay, cool. Let's see. Just trying to figure out what I need to do to make this screen reasonably right. Okay, I need to way increase the delay on this. Wow. Okay, let's see if that's better. More than that even. My setup makes no sense sometimes. So I'm currently rocking like 5 second delay on the top camera to make this all work right. It's getting closer. Way closer. Go up to 6 seconds? How is this so lagged? That seems crazy. Alright, well that's close enough. Whatever. So yeah, the warrior actually managed to beat the mines and stuff like that, which pretty good. Got a bunch of gold to burn here. Let's see. Increasing your max health and increasing the health when you go between floors seems to be like the best bang for the buck as far as upgrades are concerned. So, let's see how this looks now. Well, whatever. It'll be a little bit delayed, that's fine. So now I've got the warrior dude unlocked to the point that I can play him in the tower. God, how is this so delayed? That seems crazy. Alright. Does that look better now? Well, whatever. It's fine. Gems and coins and stuff. All right. Yeah, I'm kind of starting to enjoy the this dude more than I like the Rogue, as weird as that is, because like originally I hated the warrior. And now this is not delayed at all, right? Hang on, I really want to fix my camera so it's right. I should really buy a better capture card, so I just don't have these kind of like weird tech problems with my different stuff. Let's try that, see if it's better. Alright, so I need to go back to like 3.5 seconds or so. Whatever, I'll just deal with it. Still really don't like the mage too. Like I have never been able to make it past the first floor as the mage. My camera seemed pretty close, and I'm happy with that. Alright. Second floor of the tower here. Taking a little bit of damage, but that's okay. Have a ton of points in getting health back between floors. Got some random plot here from the ghosts. Took a bit of damage there, but I don't know. Still think that this run is okay overall. I think the reason I like the warrior so much is because against pigs, the dude is like incredible. It's like there's nothing better than coming across a room full of pigs. So we're on the threshold of me not healing back to full when I go up to the next floor, which may or may not be. Now I'm certainly not going to heal to full on the next floor. Here's the way down. The question now is, do I want to try to get greedy and see if there might be a weapon upgrade around the corner here, or do I just want to say screw it and go down? Honestly, the warrior upgrades like aren't as substantial as the other classes, it seems like. Nowhere close to being full. There's a door, so that means some fighting to be done here. Ugh. I have my stuff all charged up and everything. Well, that messed me up real big time. Alright, so hope is not lost. Tough orc guys or whatever these dudes are, like, real pain. That dude with the mask or whatever it is. I'm on the verge of having taken enough damage that this run is probably not going to reach the boss. Unless I get like super lucky with healing stuff. If I get a potion or let's see what's down this way. Yeah, so not great here. Man, my stuff is so out of sync. I don't know how to fix that. All right, let's see what this does. Haste. The blue slimes are super annoying. Alright, so this run is really starting to look bad. Right now. Especially because I'm just like whiffing on this slime, which that's always awesome. Oh, dead. Alright, so swing by the clean slime on the fourth floor. Don't think I have enough to upgrade anything. Well, I can upgrade this, but I don't know. I hate using axes. The shields are so much better. So I think I'm gonna hold off on doing any kind of upgrades. See if we do better this time around. So not too much damage yet, which is all right. This looked like it was gonna be such a huge week for iOS game releases, but like honestly, after like I played all the games that I streamed yesterday, and I mean none of them really kind of. I don't know. Maybe the problem is that last week was just so good that this week just seems kind of like all right in comparison. Cool. Here's a forge here to get more items. Alright, so I kind of like this one better in my experience. The Bane of Bones, it's slow, but it has a, like, it changes your charge attack. So you do kind of like a more, like, leaping thing. It does really good work. Alternatively, this other one down here seems like, I don't know, like, slow but inflicts more damage with a strong power attack. Like, I don't know what's better, because I use my power attack so much that I feel like kind of like really souping that up is probably good, because like look how much like I really have like a dash that goes in, and it seems like it does way more. So we'll charge up and go in here, and you guys kind of see how it goes. So like now my stuff dazes dudes, but the problem is you swing so slow that you really can't do like huge wave clear. Problem is, it seems like you basically need to have a full. Full energy bar in order to use your jumping thing. So I don't know, like that upgrade might have not been that great. Like that's kind of the problem with the Warriors. None of the upgrades are like a super clear win. Alright, so I don't really have any fantastic items either. So like right there, that not having the energy to do my charge attack is really not great. Man, this is nuts. I actually might have like really messed up this run by getting this weapon, in fact. Because like the problem is you don't start doing damage until you, this is stupid. You don't start actually doing damage until you complete the jump.
So you can be totally blocked by these dude's shields before you even do it, and then, like, you know, if you see it uses your entire energy bar. Which is not great. Like, I really wish I didn't upgrade this. Swinging so slow now that it's hard to interrupt casters, which is not a good thing. See, if I had the regular sword there, I would have been able to just dash in and interrupt both those guys, but, you know, because of the jump effect on this, I actually got hit by them. It's pretty terrible. Yeah, this was a really good run before I decided to upgrade this. This is terrible. How much worse I'm doing ever since I got this stupid axe. So still persevering, like going through surviving, even though the swords that I got sucks. Yep, like I got bounced off there trying to break that dude's shield, that's terrible. Missed again on breaking his shield. This magic dude is just... oh, I'm dead. Maybe not quite, but... definitely on the road to dead. Yeah, because I'm going to have a real hard... oh, shit. I'm going to have a real hard time dealing with these two dudes. Alright, cool. So if I can... and another problem, like this... I swing so slow with this that I can't interrupt their sword swinging, so... wah, wah, wah. Blythe the Warrior. Fourth floor. A decent amount of gold, so... whatever. Let's see. I don't know. Should we do, like, a Hearthstone arena run, I guess. I have tons of gold coins, so we could always do that. That's fun. Alright, so... oh shit, I'm not logged into Battle.net. Let me fix that real quick. Battle.net password is so complicated. Okay, cool. Alright. So, April 2014 season, I achieved the rank of 19. So not great, but I kind of just wanted the card back, so I got the Pandaren card back here, so that's kind of neat. Got 6 bonus stars, which should give me what, like rank 20, 23. So I need to win 5 games of the Paladin or Priest and play 20 minions that cost 3 or less. Alright, so let's see. You can change your card backs by going to the options. And let's see. Right now I have the one that you get for the Fireside Gathering thing. Alternatively, I can switch to the Pandaren ones, which, I mean, I guess that's kind of cool, right? Let me fix my camera delay. Whatever, screw it. All right, so I kind of like these ones better. Everyone's gonna have the ranked ones, so who cares? So the way the arena works is that I'm gonna pay 150 golds to get into the arena. So it's all based on random cards here. First I get to choose my hero. So Hunter definitely always seems best right now, kind of overpowered. So when looking for arena dudes, you can either use a list, which kind of seems like cheating to me, to do kind of like a power curve. Like they call them tier lists, where you can look up your particular class, and then you can look up let's look up a hunter tier list right now to see what it says about this. Hunter arena tier list, and there's just like a ridiculous amount of these. So let's see what it says for hunter stuff. This is not the one I was looking for before. I don't know, well, whatever. So the three choices that we have here are the Wild Pyromancer, which after you cast a spell, deal 1 damage to all minions. The first minion you play each turn costs 1 less through the Pint-Sized Summoner. Or the Ancient Mage, which gives adjacent minion spell damage plus 1. I don't know what is... I wish I could find the spreadsheet thing that I was looking at before. All right, so of these rare cards, none of them seem like they are that fantastic. Pint-Sized Summoner is listed under average. Wild Pyromancer is also average, and Ancient Mage is listed as terrible. So this is kind of, you can see like the how these work here. I just pasted the link in chat. So If you're not really that familiar with the way that these like kind of things work, so I guess we'll do Pint-Sized Summoner because like that has good synergy with the minions that my hunter is gonna have, and it seems like you have unlimited time to do these, so you can like really think about it and kind of like research it and all that stuff. So let's see. From here we have Spellbreaker, Murloc Raider, or the Magushan Warden. It's probably not a bad idea. I mean, none of these guys are beasts. So I don't necessarily think that any of these are necessarily that strong of a pick. I don't know. Man. I guess it's good to have silence in there in case we need to break through. Breakthrough Taunt or something like that. So Murloc Raider is garbage. Novice Engineer kind of always seems pretty good because that gives you card draw, I guess. But I don't know how that's going to be with a hunter because
it's not a beast. So I'm gonna say that or the Wolf Rider. We'll get some card draw, because card draw is always good, I guess. Animal Companion seems like the clear win here. The only thing that I think could possibly be better, because I definitely don't want my minions to cost more. Restoring health is good, but these hunter specific cards are too hard to pass up. Looks like we got super lucky with another Animal Companion here. Hang on, let me ban this spammer. Try to ban the spammer. All right, cool. All right, so Animal Companion, I guess. Where's your friend Hunter is gonna bring out a boar, which is pretty good. The Stranglethorn Tiger is a beast. I don't know which is gonna be better. Stranglethorn Tiger is listed as good. See, like, the problem with these kind of deck lists is that you get yourself in this thing where you're just like, all right, here, I guess we'll do a Young Dragonhawk for the beast thing. God, Flesh Eating Ghoul is usually really strong, but I don't know if I want a Hunter's Mark instead. Because this Flesh Eating Ghoul is a problem, especially if you get it out early. Where is this on my list? Fishing and Gold also listed as average. I don't know. I guess we'll go for more Hunter cards. The Core Hound is kind of beefy, but still, I don't know. No, if in this situation, Snipe is going to be better than the Razorfen Hunter. Snipe could be okay. We'll try it. I don't know. My deck is... So you want to kind of keep, like, as you're doing this, and, you know, I'm like, by no means a expert here, but, you know, you want to keep an eye on your mana curve. So Angry Chicken will not have a way to enrage him, so he's kind of garbage. Mana Wraith, all minions costing one more is bad for me. Light Warden, whenever characters heal, gain +2 attack. Like, all of these seem to be not great. Although, Light Warden could be good against... something that can, I don't know, let's see here. Yeah, none of these are great. I'm like, Light Warden is listed as terrible, which I would agree. Angry Chicken is also pretty bad. And Mana Wraith is also listed as terrible. So, kind of agree with all this. Let's go with the Angry Chicken. So no solid way to give the Raging Morgan enrage, because I don't have any kind of like single target stuff, and that seems like where his strength is. South Sea Deckhand might not be bad, but the problem with him is I don't have a weapon yet, and like his synergy requires a weapon. So I don't know, I guess let's do the dude with taunt, just because, I don't know, I guess you can always use more meat shields, right? Stone Tusk Boar with charge seems like a win. Over, because I already have a dude with Wind Fury. Leper Gnome is typically pretty good though. I don't know which I want to go with here. I guess Leper Gnome can do some good work, even though he's not a beast. Like, oh, Starving Buzzard, that's fantastic. Definitely need that. Ironforge Rifleman seems like the clear pick there. Explosive Shot is killer. Oh shit, Emperor Cobra is so good. I don't know what I want of these. Because the Emperor Cobra is like really, really, really good removal. But Explosive Shot is also really good. I guess let's do Explosive Shot. So we'll do another one of these guys with stealth, because my curve is kind of really low, so I feel like I need some beefy dudes for... Oh, Harvest Golem. Harvest Golem seems like an instant pick. 24/7, like, doesn't matter. Always take Harvest Golem if he's there. Let's see. I don't know if Misdirection or Flare is necessarily better. They both seem pretty equal. I think Flare could potentially be more useful. Oh, Unleash the Hounds. Let's do... Oh man, this is like... What sucks about this is these are all really, really good cards. So... Unleash the Hounds is killer. Kill Command is targeted removal, and Tracking is card draw. Why does this have to be a pick here? Because I don't really have a good way to buff the Hounds. 5 damage is pretty good, and I have a lot of beasts. I'll probably regret if I don't take that or Unleash the Hounds. All right, so there's another Flare. That's not great. Defender of Argus seems like a pretty strong pick all the time. Although I don't know over another Flare. And I guess we're kind of low on 4 drops, so let's take that dude. Another Animal Companion. That's going to put me at 3 Animal Companions. That seems good. Chillwind Yeti is always great as a 4 drop. Ironbeak Owl is always good. Scavenging Hyena seems like it could be really good. Although over the Booty Bay... Well, Raid Leader is probably... I don't know, like I'm kind of running out of picks here, so I kind of need to... Oh, Timberwolf, that's great. Another Tracking. Alright, I think I'm going to take Kill Command this time around. Like, Tracking is so good. Another Timberwolf. This is actually turning out to be a surprisingly decent deck. Now I'm gonna do this. Another Stranglethorn Tiger. Eaglehorn Bow. Alright, so overall, a pretty decent deck, I would say. 3 Animal Companions and 2 Timberwolves I'm like really happy with in an arena run. So let's see how we do here. Let's see what we get for our first game. See, my phone is buzzing while it's looking for an opponent. UPS delivered some crap to me. All right, let's see what we got here. So Hunter with a pretty good array of cards versus a Warlock. I don't know about the starting hand. Like, I want the Buzzard, but I don't know if I want it yet.
Chillwind Yeti is pretty good, but I think I'm gonna throw him back and see what we get. All right, well, I'm satisfied with that. Because the hyena either will need a... all right, well... Flare is going to be kind of useless against this guy, so we'll just cycle it out, get a card. Oh, shit. All right, cool. So that's not terrible. Leper gnome. All right, cool. I'd say we do leper gnome next turn. We do harvest golem, and then the turn after that, I poop out both those guys. That way, I get guaranteed card draw off of the starving buzzard. And worst case, this dude kills this guy and takes 2 damage. So. Let's see if he attacks me or... Alright, I'm satisfied with that. That's the net loss for him. Unleash the Hounds too. This is turning out... See, now this is kind of an interesting thing because... kind of want to hold on to my Unleash the Hounds and Starving Buzzard until like he really kind of gets a bunch of dudes out. Because it seems like in the arena mode, you really want to... You end up with like super creature centric decks, I guess. Much like drafting and Magic and crap like that. So let's see what this dude's gonna do. So I really hope I get a 4 drop. All right, cool. Oh, this is actually like really turning out good. All right, so kind of take away. I don't know if I want to take away this dude's. I mean, so far, like, I don't want to waste this turn. Like, I can shoot at him and then basically do nothing. I kind of would really like to try to combo out with Unleash the Hounds and, like, these 3 dudes. Like, if I can get 6 mana... Yeah, let's just do this. Whatever. Silence that dude. Attack with this guy. Because, like, getting an Unleash the Hounds combo cooking in Arena is going to be insane. Yeah, so kill that guy all day. I don't care. He doesn't have Enrage anymore. So hopefully he starts attacking me instead of my minion guys, because... I'd really like to have at least, like, if he plays... Alright, cool. Let's see what he does. Alright. So that's at least 2 hounds. Alright, so... guess we, get this dork out and then shoot with... my bow, and then hope next turn he has enough minions out that it makes a difference. Alright, so shoot. This to the face, that to the face. And turn. Alright, let's ban this dude. Tiny butt 687. Okay. Please play a minion. No. All right, well, that's fine. Either way, I'm gonna kind of explode next turn. So the order I wanna do this in, I think, is the buzzard, the starving hyena, and then let's unleash the hounds. So decent card draw off that. All high value cards, so not really going to complain. And then just attack in here. And turn. Oh yeah, sacrificing the hounds probably wouldn't have been a bad idea. But the problem with that is like, he could still attack me with the Chilwin Yeti. Although I guess I would have killed that guy. Oh, full board wipe. There goes my cool combo. Alright, so what can we do here that is going to bring us back on the board? Alright, so right now an explosive shot isn't fantastic. 4, 5, 6. Alright, so this dude with taunt will save me either 4 or 6 damage. Then I can throw out snipe. Alternative, like, the problem is if I play Tiger this turn, I'm definitely taking 10 damage next turn. I mean, I do have, like, kind of a decent lead, I guess, but it's not, like, anything that's insane. So I could work on getting both Tigers out. Well, here. We'll do a tiger and then throw out snipe too. Take our 10 damage next turn. And then see what happens. I really need 9. So many. Loot hoarder. Well, that was totally wasted. Actually, probably that was exactly what he wanted. Yeah, I think. Alright, well. Alright, so let's bust this dude out. Throw that guy here. The tiger taunt. Like, now I'm in a place where I don't really have the luxury of. Well, I guess that's not terrible. Alright, let's see what happens here. I'm not gonna take any damage this turn. So many possibilities. But if he throws everything at me, neither of us will be in an insanely good situation for next turn. I mean, I do have a life advantage. Can drop a Stranglethorn Tiger and a Chilwin Yeti, alternatively explosive shot. Alright, so he's trading me there. What's he doing with this guy? Ugh. Not great. And he's gonna swing into me for 8. Ugh, yeah, that's well played. Well,
Not fantastic. I mean, like, the only real difference I could have done is, like, switched out and played a dude with taunt instead of that tiger. But if he was holding that card in his hand to destroy my guy, like, I think he probably just would have thrown that out there anyway.
So let's see what we get this time. Otherwise, I think that game went all right.
You know, not incredible, but certainly done worse. All right, so let's see what we get here. A druid. That can be okay, I guess. Let the hunt begin. Alright, so pretty good starting hand. Hunter's Mark is not great to start, but it could turn out to be useful, so we'll keep it in case. Alright, well, a bunch of two drops, that's okay. So let's coin and then this dude so we can draw off that. Hope you like my invention. Ugh, flare, it's not fantastic. And I guess we'll just end turn. Okay. Alright, well, we can get this dude out because potentially I could get both the Buzzard and the Timberwolf out next turn, but we'll see. Because that guy is actually pretty good for me. Alright, so I think I'm gonna raid leader. I don't know if I wanna kill this dude outright. Yeah, using flare to cycle is not a bad idea. Here, we'll just do this. Train across on that, then flare, see what we get. Unleash the hound, that's pretty good, and then shoot. Killing Yeti. Well, that would have been good to keep the other thing, but whatever. Now I don't have a really strong play. I guess we could fish out more dudes potentially. I wonder if he would allow this to stay. Alright, so potentially have sort of an... Alright, so now I don't necessarily want these dudes to die because I have... all the pieces of an Unleash the Hounds combo that's pretty good.
So let's see here. Maybe we'll do that. Buzzard. Timberwolf. Unleash the Hounds. Oh, Animal Companion. That's super good. Another Timberwolf. That's good news. Alright, so nothing outrageous. Probably should have silenced this dude instead of... Oh, whatever. Got a bunch of decent cards off that. Like hardly even worth silencing now. Alright, so what is the best thing to do with our six? So I've got Learn Tiger wouldn't great. I lost my card draw engine, so that's not fantastic either. Potentially I could get this dude big. Could get a guy with taunt off of this. Nope. Alright, so let's just do the beast now. I guess we'll trade here. Turn him into a 5-3. That's pretty good. Plus 2 attack. Alright, well, either way, we're going back to a clear board state, it seems like. Not what I was expecting. Alright. What to do here? Guess we could get this dude out. Give him taunt. My seal for Argus. Attack there. Job's done. And that'll be the end of the Yeti, I guess. If he doesn't have some other crazy trick. So he's trading there. Divine shield on that too, that's annoying. Shield. Attack in with these guys. We'll see how this goes. Alright, well, I mean, that dude is. Oh, he's gonna return him to his hand. Okay. Is he gonna play him again? Alright, so I've got a potential for. Ugh, stupid angry chicken does me like no good. But I can dump my hand this turn, so. Take this guy out. guess we can throw the angry chicken out just in case he thinks that I can do something cool, which I can't. But we've got some kind of tricky decisions for him to make. I got any secret to pick from? Yeah, I got one that does 4 damage to a dude. Ugh. Swamp ooze just when he needs it. That's not great. Is he gonna attack you? Alright, so playing off the top of my deck here. I guess we'll use this anyway. Attack there. So, be able to kill this guy. Swing in for 2. So, basically, I need to survive 2 more turns and he win, and I win. Otherwise, let's see what my snipe hits here. He's probably going to play a minion. I mean, I can't imagine him not. So, unless he starts buffing up armor crazy style, like this might be in the bag, maybe? Alright, so he's gonna take 1 damage next turn. Oh, that's nice. That was like a max effectiveness snipe, too. So, let's go for anything with charge. Oh, this is actually really good. Cool. So he needs to answer with something that can silence or a dude that has taunt. Does he have a dude with taunt? Oh, yeah, he does. I don't think I have any silence. Well, that's still a pretty... It's a good card to have, because I can trade with his dude. I will give him a well played. What the hell is that? Well, this guy pulled a legendary. So I can get this dude out. Silence one of these guys. Deal with this guy here. Attack again. That might have been an overly cocky well played, like. He's holding on there. Man. All right. Something with, well, not fantastic, but he still needs to answer it. Oh shit, the dude's got lethal. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Oh no, he doesn't. He's 1 short. just gonna do this.
And give him a well played.
That was intense. Alright, so upgraded my prize key one, that's good.
Let's see what we got there.
I think he should have attacked in with everything. Like, that was... That's what I would have done. I don't know if that's the right thing to do or not. Definitely old Diet Coke. That's kind of nasty. Ugh. All right, so I don't know if this mage is gonna have any secrets. I don't want to get rid of Flair. Defender of Argus might not be good early. Whatever, we'll keep it, see what happens. Don't really have a... So that's not great. Alright, well, there's my solid coin 2 drop. Okay, that's really not good. Alright, well, explosive shot could be worse. Oh, this is really turning out not great. Those two cards are dangerous together. Oh, cool. Alright, here. I don't know who's more valuable to silence. Probably this dude, because he can get out of control, like, especially with the other guy on the field, so I'll just attack here in for one. Take four next turn, but that's alright. So... Well, I'm glad I silenced that guy, because he would have been a 3-3. Alright, so let's get our animal companion out. We'll be able to take out both, well, not take out both these nerds, but have both of them taken out next turn, and then be able to Defender Argus to get some crap up. So yeah. Well, either way, very glad that I silenced that guy, because he'd be a big problem right now. No, like, clear wins here, because I want to use this guy's thing, right? Ugh. No fantastic targets for kill command. I mean, I guess if nothing else, I can throw snipe out and then get this dude out to make him, because he's not gonna, he'll attack with his mana worm probably. He's definitely not gonna attack with Sorcerer's Apprentice. I'm gonna guess he's gonna mana worm that and then fireball it. Or just attack with, well,
Let's see what he does now. Dude's a lot less cool as a 2-1.
Well, I guess Fish of Frostbolt out of their hand's not terrible, but. Alright, so explosive shot's gonna allow me to 3-for-1 this dude. So we're gonna kind of rebuild here and see what we can come up with. Ardent Commander, that's like the best card you can have. This is pretty close to a GG. So I can silence that dude, but what good is it gonna do me? Don't have enough to get two guys out. Don't have enough to silence and kill command. Because any way you slice it, he's got lethal, because I can't kill anything this turn. I mean, like, the most intelligent thing to do seems to be to flare and keep my fingers crossed that I get a cheap beast. But even then, well, you know, Wind Fury is okay, I guess, but still not great. I guess this is like the only thing I can do to buy myself any time. But he's just gonna kill it with that guy and then swing in for 4, and that's lethal. Oh, or he can just cast Fireball. That's another thing that can happen. Keep it on. Not a fantastic run here. I kind of thought that I was going to do better with, actually have like decent card synergy in here, but can't win well. It's okay. Let's see who we find. I'm just happy that I beat the dude with the legendary. Like, I bet that dude thought he was such hot shit when he drafted that legendary, but, two animal companions, that's great. And a novice engineer. Alright, well, pretty satisfied with this. Pretty good. Do nothing turn one and then coin out an animal companion on turn two. Seems. Oh, and Unleash the Hounds too, that's great. Companion, let's see what we get. Oh, a pig, I'll swing in for 4 all day. Fish out removal for dorks at the beginning of the game and just duplicate that guy. That's gotta be kind of annoying. Alright, so next turn I got Taunt online. So, could swing in for 5 or get taunt up. I think it's probably more important now to get taunt up just in case anything crazy happens. And Raid Leader might be better when there's like some synergy with you know, like unleashing the hounds and stuff like that. So pretty satisfied with this so far. Although dude's probably got a lot of really good cards because he's not playing them, so. Maybe that or nothing that works with this situation. Alright, so. Cleared my board with Starfall, but that's okay. Because this turn, I'm gonna draw and then play my bow, I guess. Alternatively. This might be better. Then get snipe up for in the event that he actually plays anything, it will die, hopefully. Oh, but his death threat, that dude's death threat is so good. Oh, damn it. Alright, so I guess the wise thing to do is get that guy out, get a bow out. I hunt alone. I'm still kind of scared of what this guy could possibly have in his hand. I mean, he's got a lot of mana now. Alright, well, this is like the perfect time to unleash the hounds. Alright, so. Don't have any card draw yet, though. I don't know if it's necessarily. Well, fuck it. Let's just go nuts on this. Instead of getting greedy and waiting for the buzzard to come out. This dude could possibly survive this. He could kill both my dogs, go down to. Oh, that. Let's see. Alright, yeah, so he's gonna armor up. And that's all she wrote. Kill command, see ya. Wow, I'm doing decent, I guess. I'd love to show you guys the exciting conclusion of this arena run, but I have dinner plans that I need to bounce to. So thanks for watching the stream. I'll stream tomorrow if I can. I don't really know. Our podcast schedule has been kind of weird, so maybe I'll stream in the morning. Not really sure, though. So yeah, today we played, let's see.
basically a kind of a short array of games. We start out with the Star Wars Journeys, the Phantom Menace. I don't know. It's weird because like if you compare this game to like a book or something like that, like it's a really good value for kids, right? But if you like compare it to the world of iOS games, like it's overpriced junk. And you know, just an okay racing game at best. Boom Beach, you guys have seen a million times before. Wayward Souls, if you don't have it yet, like you really need to think about what you've done wrong in your life. And Hearthstone is amazing. I can't say enough good things about it. So thanks for watching. Sorry I'm cutting out a few minutes early, but kind of got a bounce. We will. I'll be back whenever I can. Monday at the absolute latest, but might stream tomorrow over the weekend if I'm bored. Might do Hearthstone, Friday Night Hearthstone. I don't know. We'll see. So yeah, have a good night, guys. And I don't see you until next week. Have a great weekend. And yeah, I don't know. I'll see you around.